Hi guys, I know I've been a bit quiet, and a lot of that is so much. Every time I go on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, everybody is just going on and on and on about coronavirus, and I can't deal with so much doom and gloom and negativity that's coming out of a lot of people. It's not me. I don't deal with that. I don't do that. It's just, if I ever do that, there's something wrong. I'm having a bad time mentally or something. And yeah, so I tend to sort of stay quiet. I do have some thoughts on this, and whilst I am only 42, I am classed as a vulnerable person because those of you who've watched around Christmas know that I spent a lot of the end of December and January having tests on my throat and basically my whole respiratory tract. And I do have a long, thin tumour down the back of my throat, which is benign, but it's restricting my airways. Aside from that, I have asthma. I have lung damage from having asthma, well, I have lung damage from being so premature. And then the asthma came about, and I wasn't treated until I was about 10 or 11 for asthma, which meant I was repeatedly having asthma attacks, and I have damage from that as well. Of course, on top of all that, I also have one side of my esophagus doesn't work properly, and also the hole in my diaphragm. So it means that my whole respiratory system it's not very good, doesn't work very well. They generally say 35 to 40% on a really good day is my lung capacity. And that's not counting now when it's winter, when it's cold, when there's things going around. So I am classed as a vulnerable person. And when a lot of people are saying, oh, it's so terrible, I've got 7 days or 14 days isolation. Really, you're complaining? I've been told to stay away from people for 3 months. So I will basically not be able to go anywhere, according to my doctors, until July. And that is if things don't get worse. So, and we know they're going to get worse. Hi, Jasper. Jasper's helping. You know, pussy cat, come here. Hi. So, I'm not going to be talking about this in lots of vlogs or lots of posts, anything like that. I'm not going to just be sitting here talking about it all the time. I will say right now, I am angry with the people who are fit and healthy, who are panic buying, and then vulnerable people, myself included. By the time we get to the shop, there's nothing there. There's so few fruit and vegetables, there's so few healthy food, there's so few snack food, there's nothing. I mean, even the dog and cat food. I mean, I know, and that's not then to mention start to mention the cleaning fluids, kitchen towel, toilet roll, anything like that. And it frustrates me so much really does. Because I have, it's not just my lungs and everything, it's, I also have fibromyalgia, which means I'm in a lot of pain. All the time I'm in pain. I can count the times on one hand that I have not been in pain in the last 7 years. There's always pain of some sort, always. So I can't do things like spring out of bed, drive the 50 miles there and back to the supermarket, to get there for 6 o'clock in the morning, to then, when it opens, to then go through all the crowds of people that are there at 6 o'clock in the morning. And, you know, they're barging out of the way, and I haven't got the energy. I have chronic fatigue at the same time as the pain. And I don't breathe very well. So what am I supposed to do? Literally, a friend of mine has ordered me a big box of toilet roll off eBay to be delivered to me, because it didn't matter what time I got to a shop. I did my best. I got there as early as I could, and the big supermarkets were out within 15 minutes. They said to me, you need to be here at 6 o'clock, and it's gone by 15:15. Because they don't have big warehouses out the back anymore. They don't stock. They don't keep a lot in stock. Everything is what's called just in time. So it's delivered just in time to be used. The only reason they've closed the supermarkets overnight, because here they used to be open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. They never closed. But the reason the staff told me, the reason they are closing now at night, is because if they don't, they can't stock the shelves. They said people are taking stuff off the trolleys that they're bringing stuff out with. They're arguing with people over. It's insane. And when you ask the staff, are we talking little old ladies here? You know, people who are vulnerable, people who are frontline workers, and they're saying no. It's not. It's never them that's doing all of this. They said it's always the people who don't need to be stocking up or staying in that are doing this. And the worst thing is, the amount of fruit and veg they're buying, most of it's going to go to waste, because you can't eat that amount. You must have a house of 6 vegans to be able to eat the amount of food they're saying, the amount of fresh produce that they're saying the average family of 4 is currently getting every time they go to the supermarket. So, yeah, and I mean, I live in the Highlands. We've only had 8 cases in the whole of the Highlands, which is a really big part of Scotland. It's basically all the sort of the central bit where all the mountains are. I know there's not many people up here, but that's why we've only got so few cases. We've only had 8 reported cases as of yesterday night when I looked. I haven't looked tonight. And then we're finding that people who've got caravans and camper vans, or even people just coming in their cars, are coming up here. They're saying they're coming up here so they can get away from everybody. They're coming up from the likes of London and, you know, really crowded cities. And they're coming up here and they're parking up in car parks and just anywhere. And they're not thinking that when they're doing that, we already, up here, we already have strain on the healthcare system due to lack of doctors. They can't get them. They just can't employ them. They're not coming. And so many of the, you know, the nurses and the like that came from other countries, they went back because they felt like Britain didn't want them anymore, even though Scotland was begging people to stay. And a lot of them went back. And we haven't got enough staff up here to cope with the people. I mean, my doctor wants to see me. And I booked an appointment the end of February. And the appointment is for the 2nd of April. That is because it's not, you know, an urgent appointment. But this is how far in advance here you get an appointment, unless you're really sick there and then. So I've had to wait 6 weeks for an appointment that's probably now going to be cancelled. And then we've got more people coming up here. And when they come up here, a lot of them are camping. We've had below freezing every night. I think tonight is the first night it's not been below freezing in, well, since the beginning of the winter. Which up here, by the way, is about October. So, in fact, we had frost in September. I remember that because it killed off some of my plants. Yeah, so these people are coming up here and they're camping. Well, because they're camping, they're going to get sick because it's very cold up here. And, you know, and they're not going to be able to get food because the rest of us can't get food. Or more to the point, those that do come up, they're then going to our supermarkets. They're taking all the food. But what about us who live here? What about the doctors and the nurses that are working stupid hours? And then when they finish work, they go to the supermarkets. And there's nothing there. There's nothing for them. There have been doctors who have been posting online and they've said, you know, they've just finished, they've done 24-hour shift. There was a nurse who'd done a 48-hour shift. And they went to the supermarket and there was nothing there. And up here, there's not enough for us, let alone hundreds of people who are coming up from other parts in the country. I just wish they'd stop. You know, don't come up here. You're going to put more pressure on a system that already doesn't work. It does work. But when you've got a pandemic, everything changes. Everything. Perfectly working systems before don't work anymore. And then when you're adding more people on top of that, it's not the fault of the NHS right now. It's not. It's the fault of stupid people. And it's not the fault of the supermarkets. It's the fault of the stupid people that are panic buying. And the stupid people that are coming up here because they think, oh, there's less people, I'll be safe up there. You might not. And you know what? If you get sick up here, you're more likely to die because so many people are coming up here and overloading everything. So yeah, why am I not talking about coronavirus? Because I've just spent 15 minutes having a bit of a rant about it. And I don't want to do that. It's not me. I don't like doing that. It's not how I want my videos to be. But I thought, I'm going to put this out there because this is why I'm not talking about it. I'm not ignoring it. I'm not deluded. I don't think everything's going to be fine and wonderful. I'm just looking at a minimum of 3 months lockdown for myself and for Asha. I'm on a farm. It's okay. But even I need to get off the farm sometimes.